Welcome back to Rock and Rattle Retreat. We're going to get a little busy here, or actually, the electrician's going to get a little busy here towards the end. So, at this point, we still haven't gotten siding. Hopefully, that is to come. But we're prepping for putting the solar stuff into the basement, which means this is where the stairs come down into the basement, left to right, and I'm going to paint this area so it's all prepped to put plywood on and the inverters and batteries on. Makes it all nice and sealed. Nice and painted. And then I got my first shipment, which is the battery boxes and the actual batteries. Now these batteries weigh, I think it was 115 pounds each. And I'm putting these down in the basement to store them. Because this was, that's a box of parts they sent, which included the cables for hooking up everything. Well, at least the batteries. There's a lot more cables that need to be done by the electrician, so. And a lot of stuff, I have no idea what that is. This is not a do-it-yourselfer type of kit. This needs an electrician, qualified electrician, to hook it up. Otherwise, the warranty is no good. So we have to spend money to get the electrician in. So we're taking this stuff down into the basement. Then we're going to stack it down here. This is before our trip. I want to have this stuff on site so if something happened during the trip, it wouldn't get lost in transit or stay in some warehouse and nobody would ever see it again. Like I said, these things are about 115 pounds a piece, and I just hauled them down here. There is 8 batteries and 4 boxes. The boxes are what we're going to put the batteries on. They attach to the actual wall. Think about that. Each box is 230 pounds. Not including the box. That's a lot of weight to hang on the wall. There's a box. In a box. Another box in a box. I don't remember what the boxes weighed, but those weren't light either. And then the inverters came in a separate shipment. And I'm going to use these forks, bolt-on forks, to put on here and get them off the back of the truck. Because I didn't want to actually drive a trailer all the way down to the shipping depot. I think that was close to 90 miles round trip. Problem is, you can't see the front of the forks sitting on the tractor. The other problem is you have to sit on the tractor for it to move. So that's why you saw me standing up there and then sitting back down. I can move it when I'm sitting, but I can't see it when I'm sitting. So I have to get up, look at it, sit down, move it, get up, look at it. Sit down, move it. Pain to do. Okay. Get that as far as we can on there. I have to physically get up there and move it onto the forks, each box. Well, we do one box to start with. And these are a bit heavier, so I just stuck them in the garage itself. go with one of the inverters. We got two inverters in total. I believe what they say, each battery is about 5 kilowatts. The inverters can handle, I don't know, I think they put out 15 kilowatts each, and then it started to rain. So it's like a mad rush to get this last one off the truck and into the garage. I thought it was going to downpour. Luckily, it didn't downpour. Okay. Months later, got the electrician in. He put 2 4x8 sheets of plywood up. Put their battery boxes on the wall. This side is empty. So we got batteries to go in here yet. That one's not even open down there. And on this other side, the battery box is sitting so close to the inverters, he had to put the batteries in the boxes before he could put the inverters on the wall. So if those batteries there go out, it's going to be a fun time getting them out of that boxes. It's just going to be a mess. We'll just have to go from the other side, because I don't want to take all the wires out. There's no wires on these yet. And I did not set up a camera down here, because I just don't want to put a camera in his face. And then we have the breaker box. Bare breaker box. So, you can see no wires yet anywhere. Okay, electrician is starting to wire stuff up. He's got some of the batteries connected together. And some of the wires run. This is another day. So he's got some of the wires in the actual inverters. Connectors. Wire chases. Conduit. Not much in wiring yet. Still don't have batteries in the other boxes behind this. Got a few wires in the panel box for the incoming. And another day. Starting to get more wires. Nothing extra in the actual breaker box. There's a few more in the inverter box. That was inverter one, this is inverter two. More stuff in the battery boxes. Not much, but a little bit. And on the other side, it's dark. There's batteries in there, and there's wires. So he has the batteries in all the boxes now, and mostly wired up. But he is not stopping there. Okay, so he's got most of it wired up now. Oh, and looky there, we got wires coming out of the ceiling. He has started running home runs, or that's what he's calling it. So it's going out to plugs to start, like the garage, the door openers for the garage, the lights, the first wire going to the light switch to power it. And then he gets them all in the box itself. And we got one plug on the wall down there, one breaker, and we got 94% on there. So we have power. A much cleaner looking. You can see the little thing there. And if I can get it open, come on, figure it out. Oh, here we go. Breakers. We have more plugs in the house. There's going to be a couple light plugs that he's going to do. Okay, I'm standing behind the camera, and here goes the garage door. And that is how noisy it is. It's like super quiet. And if you can see the motors up there, then it goes down. And then there's a lock that electronically locks. You open, it opens up.